So this is car news.
So this week, 20 years ago, Porsche was like, yo, let's surprise everyone with a V10 supercar. And the Carrera GT went like, yo, I'm the V10 supercar by Porsche. And everyone was like, yo, is that the Carrera GT, the V10 supercar by Porsche? And the Carrera GT was like, yeah. So people went like, yo, tell us like 4 fun facts about you. And the Carrera GT was like, yo, first of all, I have a V10. Second of all, it was made by Porsche. And third of all, I'm a supercar. And fourth of all, I'm gonna kill Paul Walker. And then, also this week, Ferrari was like, yo, you know this super cool car named SF90 Stradale? Yeah, the plug-in hybrid supercar? Yeah, well, it's no V10 supercar made by Porsche. But now we have it in a spider version. And you don't even have to remove it manually like the LaFerrari. You know this car that we made for poor people? Yeah, this one. And at the presentation, Ferrari was like, yo, the roof takes just 14 seconds to be deployed and can operate while the car is on the move. But like, if you drive very slow. And then they were like, yo, just to remind you, this car can do 0 to 60 in 2.5 seconds. That's impressive, right? But what's even more impressive is that its top speed is of 211 miles per hour. And everyone there was like, yo, I think I have a boner. Then there are also the SSC Tuatara. You know, this car that I kindly call Mr. Controversy. So basically SSC is like, yo, we're going to redo the top speed record. And the CEO was like, yo, we're going to redo it within 60 days. And everyone was like, yo, what the heck, man? Are you really serious? And he said, yes. So people were like, yo, do you know what road you're gonna use? And he said, nah. And they said, okay. They also said, yo, you're gonna use the driver from last time? And he said, no. And they said, yeah, but what driver are you gonna use? And he said, I don't know. So they said, okay. Also this week, the CEO of Bugatti was like, yo, frick Bugatti, I'm going back to Lamborghini. But really, he's just working for Volkswagen. Because both of them are owned by Volkswagen, also called the Nazis. But like for some time now, there was people, they were like, and basically those meant, yo, did you heard that Bugatti is considering selling to Rimac, I don't care. But did you know they consider selling to them? Yeah, that's crazy, right? Because, you know, Rimac is an electric company. So maybe we're going to see electric Bugattis. While on the subject of electric supercars or hypercars, Ferrari this week was like, yo, I don't think we're ever going to have a full electric lineup. So people were like, yo, what are you going to do if there's, I don't know,
regulations?
And they were like, yo, we're going to look into things that the narrator doesn't understand. But they're basically
alternative fuels.
By the way, if you've made it this far, maybe you liked it a little bit. So please like and subscribe if you liked it. And if you subscribed, don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you never miss an upload. By the way, if you watch Netflix, well, do you have a VPN? Because if you don't, that's basically a waste of your subscription. Because with a VPN, you basically just change the country you're in, but you stay in your house. You change the country you're in, and you get access to a whole other Netflix. So if that interests you, the link is in the description. And by the way, it supports the channel if you do. So, love ya. In a few hours from now, we're gonna have the full reveal of the Huracan STO, which stands for Super Trofeo Omologato. So Lamborghini this week was like, yo, let's tease them a little bit. And they were like, yo, from racetrack to road. And everyone was like, yo, what the heck? And basically, Lamborghini was like, yo, you know the Huracan? Yeah, yeah. Well, we've got the Huracan Performante. And now we've got the STO, which is going to be better than the Performante. And the Performante was the fastest to 60 miles per hour in our lineup. So yeah, pretty cool. And also this week, there was the Acura NSX that was like, yo, I've got a new paint option. And everyone was like, who cares? But the NSX was like, yo, it's an homage. So everyone was like, oh, that's so cool. After that, there was like Tesla, you know, with Elon Musk. They were like, yo, we're entering S&P 500, which for those who don't know, it's just a stock market thing. But yeah, Elon was like, yo, I'm joining the S&P 500. And everyone was like, yeah, that's so cool, Elon. We love you. Because, you know, Tesla fanboys. And everyone was like, yeah, that's so cool. Also this week, you know, there was this guy. He was like, yo, I'm Lewis Hamilton. And he said, yo, I won my 7th F1 title. So I'm matching Michael Schumacher. And everyone was like, yo, that's so cool. And he was, yeah, I know. And then he was like, do you know what's even cooler? And people were like, no. And he was like, yo, I'm 35. And you know who was 35 when he won his 7th F1 title? Michael Schumacher. So basically, what I'm trying to say is that we're twins, basically. And after that, he was like, yo, you know what's even cooler? And people were like, nah. And he was like, I won the title in Turkey. And people were like, huh? Turkey, like the meat? And he was like, no, the country. And people were like, oh, okay, I thought you were talking about the turkey, like the thing that we do for Thanksgiving and all. And he was like, no, I was talking about the country. And then he said, hey, that's the end of the video.